Don't mind me, just walking down the street. Whoa, falling there. It's right on the bottom right there. I think you can see it. It's the outline of an armored catfish or a pleco just laying there on the bottom. I'm gonna outline it right now with a marker on the screen. He's right there. Pleco or a armored catfish. Oh God, it's high tide. We're fishing in there. High tide right now though, it's kind of cool. So we're gonna hop and skip over to those rocks right there from here and get a little bit wet. What do you think? My little fishing spot here. In the middle of a ditch, in the middle of a little stream somewhere. And we got some bait here, got some worms. I'm gonna put a nice worm on a hook. And we're gonna catch us some fish in the middle of the new abnormal, folks. That's the way we're doing it today. I'm gonna find a new way of relaxing. If it means sitting inside of a municipal ditch and catching a fish or two, so be it, folks. Let the cards fall where they may. Right? There it is. That's probably closer than I'm going to get to where I want to be. So, yep, it's a nice little perch out here in the middle of the swamp, better known as Florida. And this is just a little homemade float right here, nothing fancy. I'm gonna wrap that rubber band one more time around there. Give it a little bit more tension because it's kind of pulling loose there. Okay, and in you go. Right there is where I want it, at the wall. I don't know if you can see it because of the lighting right there, that sun. But, you know, we'll see if we can't catch a fish for you. And now we go to Zen fishing silence mode. Municipal ditch silence. This is how we meditate. One thing we do need to be aware of is alligators. So, standing up isn't always a bad idea. Every once in a while, alligators don't like tall objects. There we go. I want it right at the wall right there. The walrus. Oh, there we go. We got a fish. There he goes. He's taking it. He's taking it. We got him. We got him. Oh, I lost him. I lost him. Here. Put it back out there real quick. There's a little bit of bait left on there. We'll do is we're gonna grab another piece of bait in the meantime while it's out there. That's what I do is I leave it out there while, if even if there's a little tiny piece on there, there's a fish, see? While I'm getting this bait, I'm catching, you know, if I'm doing this for dinner, you don't wanna miss any opportunity, or if you're in a tournament, you don't wanna miss opportunities. So these are some good tips to know. Tip alert, tip alert. And anyway, we just string the earthworm right on the hook here, nothing fancy. Leave a little dangle hanging off the bottom, something that could be picked off by the fish. And, you know, let the competition begin with down there with all the fish, and you'll end up with more of a success rate. Like I said, every once in a while you stand up just to let the alligators know who's boss. Which is kind of funny because they're always boss. This reel is starting to give me some problems, and I don't know why. Oh, I do know why. It needs a little bit of oil and love. Screws could be loose, I'm not sure. It's really, I put it through the paces. And it's got a lifetime guarantee, or at least 25 years. It's from Shakespeare. You know, they have a pretty decent warranty. Guarantee, whatever. T. There it goes. I think it just needs a little oil, a little bit of love. Hasn't been cleaned in a while. See, this is the harbor side here, but it doesn't mean there's no gators in there, you know? So I really do have to kind of watch myself and be careful. They could sneak up on you, and that's just not a good thing to have happen, obviously. We don't want it up there now, do we? Gotta get this hat over my eyes here. I can't see anything with that sun in my face. We're at a bait on there. He ate everything. Let me get another worm out. Now these are food fish, of course, tilapia. You eat them and all the time in restaurants. Spend a fortune on them too. Pretty expensive nowadays for something so common. And they're all over the world, you know. They're all over. They're very ubiquitous species, very prolific. Am I hearing voices? Is it the voice of environment past or something? What is that? Anyway, here we go. There's a bite. There it is. Oh, we got him. We got him. Whoa. Big one. Might be the same fish. Same fish. Pretty little green tilapia. There you go, buddy. I'll see you in a couple minutes. If we catch the same fish on every single catch, now there's a thing for you. You just have one fish that you catch all day long. One fish. A quick rise just to check on the gator. Anybody's around me? No? We're safe. We're good. We're clear. Once in a while, a manatee will come in here too. And they can be a little bit frisky. Nope, that's a different fish. That's a Mayan cichlid. Mayan cichlid. Pretty. Ooh, bye-bye, buddy. Still got worm on there. You hear voices? You hear voices too? No, there's, well, I mean, I'm outside. I mean, there's people around, you know, so of course you're gonna hear something. That's called people. Those voices that I hear. Actually, the sunglasses off, I can see the float better. I'm blinded by that sun glare in the water. But, you know, c'est la vie. Life is difficult sometimes, you know, we have to suffer through it. Look, I have a floating bait box here, so I could just basically float my bait box next to me, put it on some sticks, and I can actually put my feet over here. See how nice that is? Floating bait box, and it also keeps the worms cool, so the worms aren't going to overheat in the sun, because they will bake in there. It's like a literal oven. Okay, I'm going to get another worm. I put it out there first. And I put it in my rod holder, which is my bottom here. Just jam it between my foot and my behind. Just hope I don't get a big fish and give me a little bit of a wedgie. All right. I don't know about you, but this place is pretty relaxing, you know? I pretty much dig it here. It's kind of nice and quiet. A little bit of a waterfall in the background, you know, it's kind of nice. Wouldn't be an episode without a stick, would it? I can't ever get have an episode without a stick. That's not possible. That's not G-Fish Outdoors. If you're not catching sticks, we're not talking fish. So I got some other bait today. Today we're gonna try some of these eggs here. We get these little tiny eggs from the grocery store. These little guys. So we're gonna string the hook up with a bunch of these little eggs and see what we can't catch. Well, we lost one. I'm gonna feed that one to the sea. And where the heck are the other ones? Oh, I don't know where they are. They're not in there anymore. Oh, there's a couple. Here, put a couple of these eggs on. This show comes equipped with background music from Urbania. Folks, I hope you had some fun today. You know, get out a little bit. It's very peaceful. I didn't talk as much as I usually do. Kept it a little bit less today so you can enjoy a little bit of relaxation and thinking time, you know, just to or maybe not thinking time, you know, to unthink a little bit. You know, we're trying here, trying to do everything we can to get through every day, and it's almost impossible. Oh. They like the eggs. I don't think I have any more. I think I'm almost out of bait, folks. Might be the end of the day on this episode, but there's plenty more online. Hey, look at that. We got a couple more worms. We're not done yet. A few more fish, a few more worms. You know how we roll. Just killing time, folks. Just killing time. You know, and it's not even killing, it's not wasting it. This is quality time for me. I don't see this as killing time, actually. Let me take that back. This is actually quality time. We're getting away from some really stuff that we can't even handle and control. Folks, I think this is the last cast, maybe. I don't know if I got another worm after this one. This is a big worm, though. We're gonna string this guy all the way up. Make sure he's all the way on the hook. We can't afford to lose any of it. Maybe we can catch two fish on one worm. Sometimes you get two birds with one stone, which is horrible. Isn't that horrible? Why would you throw rocks at birds? Don't do that. Just don't do that. Please, don't do that. Throw rocks at me instead. I'll be happy to be the target. I mean, unless you're going to eat the bird. Whoa, what's coming at me? I saw like that little wake in the water coming at me like a dolphin. Oh, we got a nice fish on that time. Oh my God, it's the littlest of all of them. And he actually pulled that entire float down. The smallest one was the only one that pulled the float down. Come on, little buddy. That's the tiniest little fish. He managed to get the whole float down. I can't see it. Can you see the float? No, I could see it actually. There, something's on it. We got him. It's Godzilla. It was a shell cracker. Different fish. Sorry I didn't get to show you. Maybe we'll get another shell cracker and I can show you. When you clean your reels, folks, don't spray the water heavy into the reel, because then you're pushing all the grit and grime into the mechanisms. Your best bet would be gentle. Put it in the shower with you, take a shower, take your rod and reel in the shower and wash it there. That's what I used to do all the time with my offshore equipment. I would take them in the shower with me after I was done shark fishing. I smelt worse than the gear did, so you know, I would go in there and clean it up. See if there's any more worms left, folks. This might be the last bit here. We got one and an egg. All right, we got a little bit. We got enough to close this out, maybe with a fish. Let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. At least we had some time together, which is nice. I enjoy it. Hope you do. I know you're there. I pretend you're here. It's all I could really do. You know what I mean? See what I have on there? We'll see what happens. There it goes. See, there's bubbles right there. Not the clown either. I mean, it could be a gator. I gotta keep my eyes open. When I see bubbles, you gotta watch out for bubbles. Gators live on that side. They could just flop right off the other side here. It's nothing gonna stop them. This water's not salty enough to keep alligators out, and they're in the harbor all the time. So that's why you gotta be careful. And I'm being peculiarly careful when I go into these areas. If you see me out at the ranch, you know that I hang out with gators all day long out there, so I know what they're capable of. They could snatch me right off this rock right now. I would have nothing to say about it. There we go. I pulled it away from him. He'll come back if he wants it. There he goes. Got him this time. Folks, we got a winner. There he is right there. King of the Mayan cichlid. The king of the Mayan cichlid. And there he goes. And folks, it's been another really fun day with you out here. I really enjoy this. Hey, let's see. Wait a minute. We got another little bit of bait. I'll put it out there while I say goodbye to you. Well, folks, I just want to say thank you for coming out fishing with me. I'm going to put you on my knee. There we go. So I'm going to get one more cast in here while I say goodbye to you. And got a little bit of bait left on that hook. And, you know, I just want to say thanks. And, you know, I'm glad we had a chance to come out here and some time together to do nothing and just relax and just focus on a little bit of, focus on play a little bit, you know. Playing is good. You need to play. You need to give yourself a break. You need to take five. It's really important. If you don't take five, see the tide's going up, by the way. See that dark line? That's the water receding out. You can see it over there too. Cool, huh? So in essence, all I just, I do this because of why? Why, Frank, why do you do that? Why do you sit on a rock in the middle of nowhere and put it on YouTube? What are you doing? Well, I'm trying to give you something to look at, first of all. You know what I mean? I'm the content maker. I make content. So I'm trying to give you something a little bit better than the normal asininity that people do. This is a different type of asininity, a completely different one. And this is my own brand of asinine. And I think we're not going to catch any more fish because that bait's pretty much useless. It's basically just the shell of the worms. But whatever, man, you know. Hey, we got out today. We had some fun. I'm sitting on a rock. Oh, boy. I think I just broke my spine a little bit. That's okay. We don't need that thing, do we? We need that spine. But yeah, this is what I do. So if you like it and you want to join and subscribe and become part of the subscribing nation of subscribers like myself on Facebook and YouTube that we subscribe to things, like magazine subscriptions. You have to realize that inherently in that subscription thing, there's a cost that eventually we're gonna be dealing with the outcome of being paying for stuff like this. So at least for now I can, how are you folks? At least for now I can give you something for free. You can enjoy a little time with me out here fishing. From G-Fish Outdoors Adventures, I wish you guys the best here in the ditch, municipal waterfall, tunnels of love, or look, you have three different choices here. You can pick the tunnel of love, the tunnel of whatever, and that one. Or no, four choices. Wow, we give you an extra choice here. We got a mangrove tree, can't beat that. All right, look, it's nature. It's the middle of suburbia, urbania. It's what I have. It's what I'm trying to give you a little bit of insight. You can go out in a ditch, have yourself some fun. Get away from that computer for 5 minutes or so. Just do this. What can it hurt? You don't need expensive gear. This is a $10 rod, $15. So get yourself out there, have some fun. Enjoy life a little bit. For Frank, underneath the upheaval of the world, I wish you a happy day. And as they say at Disney, have a magical day. Bye. It's a small ditch after all. It's a small ditch after all. Oh, Yvay. Ah!